as they gain more energy, they will become more disordered. The particles will become more disordered because the entropy. So and hence the entropy will increase. So the entropy is increasing. Now we come at the freezing, the melting point of a solid, which is 273 Kelvin, because 0 degrees Celsius. Let's take. So I've taken water in this case. Water is the example. So for water, the melting point is for ice, the melting point is 0 degrees Celsius, which is 273 Kelvin. So at 273 Kelvin, the ice will melt. So I will have a vertical change over here. So this is approximately vertical. My handwriting is bad. So this has to be vertical because the temperature does not change during melting. It remains constant. And when all of the solid has melted into a liquid, then entropy will continue to increase. And as entropy continues to increase, it will form a gas. Now, as it has formed a gas over here at 373 Kelvin, because the boiling point of water is 373 Kelvin, which is 100 degrees Celsius. So again, there will be a change of state. So I'll have a vertical line over here. And again, as all the liquid turns into gas, then there will be only increase in entropy because the gas molecules will start gaining energy. So let's just interpret this graph over here. We have zero entropy and zero Kelvin over here. The temperature is zero Kelvin, so it exists as a perfect crystal. And then as we heat it, as the temperature increases, then it will gain energy and hence it will become more disordered. And as it becomes more disordered, the entropy will increase. As 273 Kelvin, where ice turns into water, there will be a steep increase in entropy, because as you can see, it's a vertical line. There will be a steep increase in entropy, which indicates that temperature does not change during melting. So, there will be a change of state. The temperature is not changing, but there will be a change of state. And the change of state will indicate that the entropy has drastically increased, because a liquid is much more disordered than a solid. So there will be a steep increase in the entropy. Then again, when I heat my liquid, the entropy will increase. It will increase again because the particles will start gaining energy, and hence they will become more disordered. So the entropy will increase. Now at 373 Kelvin, where water turns into a gas, which is steam, water vapor, not steam. Sorry. So when water turns into water vapor, then there will again be a steep increase in entropy because there is a change of state. So and gases are much more disordered than liquids. So there will be a steep increase in entropy, and there will be no change in temperature, because when a change of state is taking place, there is no change in temperature. We know the rule. So and then again, when it has become a gas and we continue heating the gas beyond 373 Kelvin, then entropy keeps increasing because the gas particles gain energy and they become more disordered. So to summarize all of this, as a solid turns into a liquid, entropy increases because liquids are more disordered than solids. So we know this. As a liquid turns into a gas, entropy increases because gases are more disordered than both liquids and solids. We know this as well. As an ionic solid dissolves in a liquid, entropy increases. Now this is simple. This happens because this is an ionic solid, NaCl. So this is one molecule. This is one unit, right? This is one unit of NaCl. But when I dissolve it in water, it dissociates into Na plus aqueous ions and Cl negative aqueous ions. So from one unit, I'm getting two units. And as I'm getting two units, the entropy is increasing because these are more disordered. This is an ionic solid, which is much more ordered, but these are ions which can spread around the entire liquid, so they are much more disordered. So as an ionic solid dissolves in a liquid, entropy increases. And as the final point, as the temperature of a substance increases, entropy increases. Obviously, there is a gain in energy, so there is more disorder. So we have done entropy changes accompanying physical changes. Now we'll do entropy changes accompanying chemical changes. So if the number of moles of products is greater than that of reactants, then entropy increases. Now